Hi, fourth grade. Welcome back. So today we're going to be starting our first project in abstraction. So if you were here last time, what we did was we created some abstract selfies, and you might be getting those back today. It depends if I had them printed or not. Now, who could raise their hand and tell us what abstraction means to them? So you can say it in your own words. All right, if I could get someone to raise their hand and tell us what abstraction means. All right, I hope someone said that it doesn't look very real. It looks imaginary. Maybe the colors aren't quite right, or it looks like it would be imaginary from a dream. That would be considered abstract.
So he's one of the most famous artists that ever lived. He's no longer alive, but his paintings are worth hundreds of millions of dollars. Pablo Picasso is known for starting the movement called Cubism. Let's take a look at one painting in particular. What I want you to do is I just want you to look at this painting. Don't take your eyes off it. Just let your eyes kind of walk around the painting for you. And I'm going to count to 10. I don't want you to take your eyes off the paper. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Go ahead and discuss with a partner. What did you see? What did you notice about this painting? What do you think it is? Go ahead and talk to one person nearby. Awesome. So I hope you guys noticed that it looks like these guys or girls, I don't know, you can't really tell, are playing some music, maybe a flute or saxophone, guitar. I see some music notes. So I know these things, I don't even know if I want to call them people, are playing music. So that was his style. He liked to break things down into very simple shapes. Maybe you even notice that there's a little dog over there and you can kind of see its feet. But notice that the dog doesn't look quite right. Its head is over here, but yet its feet are all the way over here. It's kind of like monster. He did this on purpose. So he wasn't necessarily bad at art. He was actually really good at art. He trained for art for several years, but he decided to paint this way on purpose. Now, one of his paintings, even though he's still not alive today, could go for $100 million. That's crazy because even just $1 million could get you a Bugatti. So you could buy one Picasso painting or you could buy 100 Bugattis. It's that expensive. Like I said, he used a lot of crazy shapes, but he also liked abstract instruments and daily objects. So we are going to be starting a painting project using Picasso's style of cubism and using instruments. All right, now listen carefully. You should have walked in with a pencil and a piece of yellow paper. I'll tell you why it's yellow in a second. But I'm going to pause this lesson real quick because I wanted to tell you about what we're doing next time. So next time that you guys are going to see me, we're actually going to be doing clay. So I know that sounds crazy, Mr. Buffett. Why are we starting two projects at the same time? Well, this clay project is going to need to dry, and it's going to take a few weeks to get into the kiln. The kiln is that big oven that we fire clay in. So what I thought we would do is we would start this painting project today, do a clay project next time I see you, and then while we're waiting for this to dry and go through the kiln, we will be finishing this project. So that way when we finish painting this, we will start painting the clay and start doing this weaving. But I'll tell you all about that next time. Double check and make sure that you have the paper. Go ahead and sharpen your pencil using the sharpener in your bin and give me a thumbs up to show me that you are ready. All right. So the very first thing that I want you to do is find the bottom left-hand corner. I need you to write your name right down here. And then I'm also going to have you write your class code. I'm going to write your class code on the board. Give me a thumbs up when you have it. All right. I'm just going to put class code number because I'm talking to all classes. If you could please put a little tiny box, not a big one, around your name and class code because this is going to be a painting, but I need to know who it belongs to. So we're just going to leave this tiny little box just for our name so we won't forget it. All right. So here is the deal for today. You kind of have three different things to do. The very first thing you're going to do is you're going to find an instrument and draw it. So I'm going to have this yellow folder on the middle table, and it's going to have some different instruments inside. I have DJ booths. I got violins. I got maracas. Whatever you feel comfortable doing. Some of them are a little bit harder, so if you want a challenge, you can go for it. Some of them are a little bit easier. Basically, you are going to draw one of these instruments over here on the yellow piece of paper. Now, we are not using the iPads for this. I have enough instruments for you to choose from. The reason that I have the paper yellow is so that you can't cheat. No cheating. This is not about making it look perfect over here. You can draw it bigger. You can draw it smaller. Maybe you can do more than one instrument. But I just want you to try your best. If it doesn't look right, that's actually a good thing because remember, we're studying abstract. You can make this realistic or you can make it abstract. I'm going to show you examples of both. So on one, I'm going to do some realistic instruments. And then on another one, I'm going to show you what it might look like if you decide to abstract it. So here is an example of what yours might look like if you decide to do it realistic. So if you really want to take that image and copy it to your paper, that's totally fine with me. That's up to you. But even then, like I was looking at this and I'm like, oh my gosh, I cannot do all those lines. So I just made it easy for myself and I kind of made it up in there. If it's stressing you out, don't worry. Just make it easy for yourself. This is the one that I like. I'm probably going to paint this one. But I wanted to create an example for those who wanted to do abstract. Because remember, Picasso made millions of dollars making things abstract. So you can too. This one, I took this instrument, but I on purpose made it crazy. That is totally up to you. Sometimes I think these turn out really cool too. So it's totally up to you. All right, so number one is done. I drew something that I liked. Second, you are going to find a ruler. I have some rulers on the middle table. You do not need a ruler with numbers. You're not going to be measuring anything. You're going to be using this as a straight edge. What you're going to do, and this is going to sound crazy, you guys, you're going to take the ruler and draw lines, splitting up your paper. And you're probably thinking, what are we doing? So I would split it up into maybe five or six different lines all the way across the paper. The reason why we're splitting it up into smaller section is that it's going to be easier for you to paint. So if you think about it, if you don't split up that background into little sections, it's going to be so boring to paint it all one color. I promise you it's going to turn out better if we split it up. You'll have some different options when we start painting, but like I said, you're going to take some lines, split up the whole piece of paper. This is going to make it look really modern, cubist, and a lot like Picasso's actual work. When you split it up, if you have your own idea for splitting it up with the straight lines, I say go with it. Look at how this person split up their abstract instrument. You can still tell it's an instrument, but the way they split it up makes it really interesting and cool. All right, we are not finished yet. I have my instruments, I have my lines, everything's split up. Now I'm going to make it bold. This is going to make it easier when we start painting, if you can really see the lines. I have the jumbo Sharpies, but I like to call them Big Bertha. And then I also have fine Sharpies, and I do want you to use both. I like to call these Fine Freddy. You're going to take these, and you're going to go over every single line. Say, every single line. That's right, every single one. Now, I want you to use different Sharpies. So let's say I start with the Fine Freddy. I'll go over some of my basic lines. And if these are dying, guys, just switch it out for another one. No use in using a bad one. We have plenty of Sharpies. But I can make it way more interesting if I go around the edges of the instruments with a big jumbo Sharpie, the Big Bertha. So I'm going to do a time lapse real quick, and I'll be right back. This project may look hard, but I'm here to help you. I want you to have an amazing piece of artwork that you'll really like. So even though I'm going to have you guys do this, I'll be here to help you every step of the way. So there it is. I'm all done. I used different line types with the Sharpie. So some are big, where I want them to be bold, and some of them are small, where it's really intricate. So this is going to make it so easy when we start painting after we start doing clay. When you are done, put this on the middle table. Please clean your area up. Please put away any rulers or pencils. And then there's one more thing I want you to do. If you finish early, let me know. Your prints should be coming in. When you are done, I'm going to have you start cutting out your prints. Basically, you'll take some scissors and try to cut these as perfect as you can. And we can start displaying these in the hallway. So as soon as you're done with the drawing part of this, we will begin, cutting these out. All right, guys, I hope you have a good one. Sorry for the long video. Have a great day.